Welcome to Fook VR YouTube channel. For those new to my channel is about programming, specifically Android programming. The video you are watching belongs to the series about Jetpack Compose. If you want to learn more about Jetpack Compose, you can refer to the link in the comment or tag on the right side of the screen. If you find the video interesting, please click like and subscribe to the latest videos, or you can come to my blog to see the latest articles. Don't forget to invite me for a coffee if the article is useful. When dealing with a recycler view, you can utilize various layout managers to position your elements on the screen differently. To make grids, as an example, you utilize a grid layout manager and afterward establish the variety of columns inside the grid. The grid you'll implement resembles what you saw in the last list example. This time, however, the elements won't scroll horizontally but will be fixed in place instead. As you see, your grid contains 10 elements distributed across 3 columns. The last row shows only one element in the first column because that's the last element in your list. Look at the main activity class. We can see a data class and list object icon resource. They use the interface test that we will code. Besides that, we have the grid screen composable function. This is the function where we will initialize the grid view. In the class library, Jetpack Compose provides us with a compose to initialize grid. It's called lazy vertical grid. I will explain the input parameter cells at the end of the video. Now follow me. When using this compose, we have to add the tag experimental foundation API. This means that this compose function may be changed or removed in the future. Next, similar to lazy loading, for each item, we initialize an item view. I call it grid icon. In the grid icon function, we will attach items to the compose icon function with the condition that the isVisible property is true, which will set the color purple or vice versa, the color transparent. I will adjust the size of the big icon a bit to make it easier to see. Now we proceed to build the application to see the result. Awesome! You have a grid of icons on the screen, placed in 3 columns. You can increase the number of icons inside the items list to make the grid scrollable. To experiment with different column counts, replace the value of column count inside grid screen with the desired value to see the result. Remember that you're limited to the number of columns that fit the screen. The lazy vertical grid class has 3 input parameters: modifier, cells, and content. Cells describe how columns form. There are 2 types of grid cells. Fix sets the fixed amount of cells on the screen. Adaptive add as many rows or columns as possible to fit the screen with the provided min size as the minimum size parameter. In the next lesson, we will gather what we have learned and try out a simple application using Jetpack Compose. See you in the next post. Thank you for watching the video. If you find it interesting, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, or you can invite me for a cup of coffee by buying me a coffee.